We're talking to Doc Marquis, ex-Illuminist. We're talking about occult holidays. We're dissecting Christmas. This is World Wisdom Radio. Sean Anthony, your host. Follow me on Twitter, @Sean_Anthony, or join me on my Facebook page, Sean Anthony, the Hip Hop Motivator. So it started with Nimrod and his son being born and December 25th. What's the significance? Now, Doc, I've had you on the show several times. You spoke about numerology and gematria, the way that the Illuminati use numbers to basically, it's the way they communicate, it's the way they do their symbolisms. Am I correct?
Yes.
What's the significance in the date of December 25th?
Well, you see, the calendar, the American calendar, has been perverted. You see, in the Illuminati, there are eight major Sabbaths, they're known as Sabbaths, in which human sacrifice must be performed. Now, this is based on a numerical pattern on your calendar. It's based on 6 weeks, then 7 weeks, six, then seven, six, seven, six, seven, all the way through the calendar. Six is the number for God, in gematria, okay? The numbers in the occult world is based upon gematria as far as the meanings, you know, the definitions. Six in gematria is the number for man. Seven is the number for God. So, in other words, what they're saying, by putting six ahead of seven, they're placing man above God. Now, this 6-7 pattern you find throughout the Bible, 6 and 7 is 13, correct?
Correct.
13 in gematria is the number for depravity and rebellion.
Mm-hmm.
So they're saying that they're rebelling against God by having these depraved occult holidays.
Let's back up a little bit, Doc. You said there's how many Sabbath days that the Illuminati has?
There's eight.
Eight, okay. And you also said that these eight Sabbath holidays that the occult has are days that human sacrifices must be performed?
It's all based on the ancient Druid practice of a Celtic nation.
So who's dying? Who's getting sacrificed on Christmas and these other occult holidays?
Unfortunately, and I must say it's unfortunate, but it's too easy to get a human sacrifice. They're wandering teenagers looking for a good time. Runaway, Skid Row bums, paper girls, paper boys. They have breeders. They'll go to bars where people are lonely and they're easily picked up. It's too easy to get a human sacrifice. The fact of the matter is, according to the FBI report, 1 million people are reported missing in America every year. Now, 100,000 of them are never seen again.
Whoa.
That's from the FBI reports.
We're talking to Doc Marquis. This is Flow of Wisdom Radio. Mind-blowing information that's being presented on this program, as we always do. I'm Sean Anthony, the Hip Hop Motivator, your host. Doc, you just gave out some alarming information. You said every year the FBI reported that 1 million people go missing, and only 100,000, you say, and out of that 100,000 or so,
I never seen again.
You know, I was telling someone recently, because of the news that has been going out lately about the Penn State debacle that's going on with these coaches and stuff like that, and there's been some investigative journalism been going on where people are researching. They're saying that this whole thing surrounding Sandusky, the former coach in Penn State, that there's some sort of ring that's going on, some sort of thing. And I was telling, you know, doing research for the type of shows that I've been doing lately, I've been getting privy to some very, very odd information. And one of the things that I found out, and you can let me know if this is true or not, Doc, where the people, like you said, that come up abducted, these little kids that come up missing, would you say a lot of it has to do with the Illuminati abducting people and children and using them in their little sick demonic rituals and stuff into their sick?
Of course. That's the equation right there. These people aren't falling off the face of the world.
Mm.
No, they're being used as offerings on the altars of Lucifer every eight times a year because of these occult Sabbaths, which we have allowed into the Christian church by candy coating them, by giving them a nice name and saying, hallelujah, it's a Christian holiday. I am positively disgusted at the fact that we have so fallen away from the faith. And if people don't like that, I'd say tough and get over it. And when I say get over it, I mean get into your Bibles, read it, see the truth for it yourself, and then get on your knees and repent to an almighty God, because you've allowed tradition to teach you instead of his own words.
Talking to Doc Marquis, Flow of Wisdom Radio. I'm Sean Anthony, the hip-hop motivator, taking your comments on Twitter at Sean_Anthony. Also, like my fan page on Facebook, Sean Anthony, the hip-hop motivator, and log on to flowofwisdom.com. St. Nick, where did Santa Claus come from?
Well, you see, this was a way for Satan to try to prove he's God. Remember in Isaiah chapter 14, verses 12 to 14, Satan tried to be like God.
Right.
Okay. Santa Claus is another way of doing it. Now, let's think about this for a second. Now, Satan tries to prove he's omniscient through Santa Claus, because doesn't Santa Claus know at any time who's been naughty and who's been nice?
Mm.
Yeah, that's called omniscience. Mm. And if you go to even the old traditions of Christmas, you'll find out one of them says that the winter god, and that's one of the names, of Nimrod, the winter god, taught Kris Kringle how to make a crystal ball out of a snowball so he could see all around the world at once who's been naughty and who's been nice. That's practicing the occult, isn't it?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, doesn't Santa Claus have the power, supposedly, of being omnipresent? In other words, everywhere at once, because in the Christmas story, he can deliver trillions of toys to the children in one night, can't he?
Wow.
Yeah. And because he can do all these things, he's all powerful.
He's trying to imitate.
To be
like God.
God, like the three omnis, omnipotence, omnipresence, and all-powerful. That's what he's supposedly capable of doing.
Talking to Doc Marquis, occult holidays is our topic. This breaking down facts about Christmas. Doc Marquis is an ex-illuminist. He reached the ranks of Master Witch, and he turned his life around as a born-again Christian, Bible-believing man, and now he is exposing the Illuminati and what their agenda is for over the past 30 years. Doc, let's go ahead and open up these phone lines. But before we do that, let me ask you one last question. What one message for somebody that's listening to this information for the first time, because we've discussed this on Flow of Wisdom Radio before.
Okay, and honestly, I'm not trying to toot my own horn here when I say this, but you and I have just scratched the surface of Christmas. Mm-hmm. Now, you know as well as I do, I made a DVD on the true origins of Christmas.
Yes, plug your DVDs. How can people watch this information in full detail?
Okay, well, we do have a DVD. It's called America's Occult Holidays. America's Occult Holidays will show you the true occult history to just about every single holiday you practice to this very day, including birthdays, including, obviously, Easter and that ridiculous sunrise service they have. Because Christ wasn't even didn't even resurrect when it was light outside. You go to John chapter 20, verse 1. It says Mary went to the tomb when it was dark outside. I think the Almighty, since he created light and dark, he knows the difference. So when he said it was dark outside, it was dark. You have these sunrise services because that was part of the tradition of Easter, which was created in ancient Babylon in honor of Semiramis. And then, you know, we have, as it says, the whole thing, it's almost 3 hours in length. It's called America's Occult Holidays. After this ministry, it's sold $14.95, and we have to ask $5 for the shipping and the handling because, you know, it does cost money for the package and the postage. But
what's your site, Doc? What's your website where they can get your DVDs?
Okay, the website is easy. It's docmarquee777@yahoo.com. Now, folks, you can either call up Sean Anthony to remind you of that, or if you'd like, you can get a hold of me here. My phone number you can reach me at is 402-228-9476. And if you can't remember that, folks, if you don't have a pen and pencil handy, just ask Sean. He'll give it to you.
Absolutely. Flowofwisdom.com is the website. You can get further information on how to reach Doc Marquee. Follow me on Twitter at Sean_Anthony, taking your comments, your questions, as well as liking my fan page on Facebook, Sean Anthony, the Hip Hop Motivator.